Hello, welcome to the video. In the last class we have seen the first two points told by Christine Lagarde. They are learning and labor. Now she comes to the third point. The third L is leadership that enables women to rise and fulfill their innate abilities and talents. So the third point that she would love to tell is that leadership, and it makes women to rise and enable them to fulfill their abilities and talents. Here there is plenty of room for improvement. The irony is that when women lead, they tend to do as good a job as others, if not a better job. So she continues by saying that women have plenty of space for improvement. But unfortunately, what is ironical, what is strange is that when women lead, they do it in a very well manner, but still they are not doing it. They are more likely to make decisions based on consensus building, inclusion, compassion, and with a focus on long-term sustainability. So women have an added advantage. It is that when they lead, they do it in a very well manner. They make decisions with consensus. That means they don't take authoritatively. They will be taking their decisions with including others. They will be compassionate, and when they make a decision, they focus on long-term sustainability, whether it will last for a long time. So women do take decisions with a very better manner. It is true that women sometimes lack the confidence to match their competence, but we can also see that women often they don't have the confidence to match their competence. Though they are competent, they don't take the risk. But they need to change the mindset and reset the narrative in their favor. So the first thing that women should do is that to change their mindset. They should be bold, they should be daring to take the challenges of life. So it is essential that women be ready to dare the difference, to take risks and step outside their comfort zones. So women, they are sitting in their comfort zones. If they are sitting in their family or with their friends, they feel like they are in comfort zones. So they should break these shackles and they should bear the difference, and they should take risks and challenges in order to come out from these comfort zones. They should be ready to dare the difference. Nevertheless, even those with the drive to succeed continue to face barriers. Whether we are talking about providing primary education for girls in a village or executive positions for women in business. See, even those women who have strong desire to succeed in their life, they face many barriers. And she says that whether it is for primary education or for having executive position for women in business. In two extremes, whether for primary education for a woman or for getting an executive position in business, in both these extremes, women face barriers. It's time to create a world where all women can meet their potential without impediment or prejudice, and the world will reap the benefits. She concludes the speech with a very remarkable comment. She says that it is high time to create a world where every woman can meet their true potential without any impediment or prejudice. Then only the world will reap the benefits. So in order to make the world to enjoy the benefits of the world, women should be able to meet their potential, and the three L's will help us get there. So the three L's, learning, labor and leadership, will help women to reach these, to realize their true potential. If you dare the difference, the difference will deliver. So you should be able to, you should be bold enough to take the challenges of life. They should be ready to come out from the comfort zones, to take risk and to dare the difference. Then only the difference will come out. Thank you very much. So she ends her speech with a very positive remark that if women can be empowered with all these three L's, women can deliver success. So the lesson ends with a glossary with new words and their meanings. So we will be doing the exercises and notes in the next video, and there will be a Malayalam video for the students who were not able to understand this lesson properly. So we will be winding up this lesson. Thank you.